The meeting is tomorrow, but you're not gonna go?
Yeah, why? Do you think I should?
No, I think you should do whatever's best for your family. I mean, it's not like you'd actually have any legal jurisdiction in Amsterdam anyway.
Right? I mean, it'd just be for intel.
Do you think he's gonna confess?
I do know this has been hard on Lulu. I mean, the only way she will believe that her father was capable of causing Patrick's accident is if she hears it from him herself. But at the same time, we've been away from our boy for far too long.
I get it. The man is your father-in-law. It's the definition of a conflict of interest.
Why, you say you don't think I can be impartial?
No. I know you can. I'm just saying if somebody wanted to make a case out of this, it's the first thing they'd cite in court. Like, maybe I could go in your place.
No, thanks. I appreciate it, but Patrick and Sam are on top of it. They can keep an eye on Tracy.
It's not a problem. I can leave on the first flight out of Port Charles.
Dude,
I can leave tonight.
Slow down. I said it's okay. I appreciate it, but what's going on? Why are you in such a rush to leave the country? What are you running away from?
Running away? What would I be running from?
I don't know. Maxie?
The biggest mistake of your life. That has to be major.
Okay, I know there's a lot of competition for that title because I can count my mistakes on both my hands and my feet and all the accessories that I wear. That's not even including my most recent mistake of almost marrying a complete psycho. Not to mention me, the queen of liars, being lied to for 4 months.
You know, you're rambling.
I am, and I haven't even gotten to the date with Nathan.
What date with Nathan?
The one I'm not going on.
Passed Maxie out on a date? How did that happen?
I guess it all started when we kissed in Crichton Clark.
Wait, hold up. While you were running for your lives in the clinic of hell, you and Nathan kissed?
It was a heat of the moment thing.
Maxie had just saved my life.
After Nathan saved mine.
And somehow we ended up kissing.
So how was it? Pretty amazing. No, completely amazing.
Well, I hate to be the one to break it to you, buddy, but the kiss couldn't have been that good if Maxie turned you down for the date.
It's not why she said no.
So if you had this incredible kiss, why did you turn Nathan down?
She said that she wanted to be more responsible, that she'd made a lot of mistakes recently.
I wasn't sure I was ready to trust someone again.
So I told her I'd go to the Metro Court tonight and wait to see if she showed up.
But I'm not gonna go.
Even though I think she's made up her mind.
And that's why I came to see you, my best friend. So you can tell me that I've made the right decision.
I can't tell you that.
What do you mean you don't think I made the right decision telling Nathan that I could not go out with him?
Do you remember when we were tied up?
We were tied up for days.
And you said that Nathan showing up last New Year's was a sign from the universe and that when he asked you to stay instead of going off to eat, pray, and love, that you should have listened.
Hello? We were being held hostage and I was trying to wage a psychological warfare against Levi. He felt inferior to Nathan, so I just wanted to get him all wound up so he'd make another mistake, like leave his phone around us again or something.
Okay, so you didn't mean it when you said that Nathan was wonderful.
I meant that part.
And you don't wish that you would have stayed and gotten to know him instead of going off on your spiritual
Lulu,
journey?
Of course I wish I stayed, okay? But I didn't stay. I left. And I met up with a loser, and I got conned and swindled and kidnapped. I'm trying to learn from my mistakes. I don't want to just jump into something new. I want to be responsible.
I understand that you went through a terrible ordeal.
No, we all did, because of me.
Yeah, and you're the one who got your heart broken. Look, I know how scary it is to try again, okay? But you can't hide in a corner for the rest of your life.
I'm not talking about the rest of my life. I'm just talking about right now. I went by my apartment to pick up a few of my things because I'm staying at my mom and Mac's house, and Lulu, you would not believe how many paisley print boho chic tunic tops I have. And why? Because Mr. Unmentionable likes me in them? I mean, he even ruined my sense of fashion. No, it is way too soon to go out on a date.
That sounds very sensible.
Thank you.
Except this has nothing to do with timing or paisley tunic tops. You put your heart on the line. And now you're scared that you can't trust yourself.
So you're saying I should go out with Nathan?
No, I'm saying that Nathan's a great guy. And if you want to go out with him, then you should. But it's your decision.
So that's it?